A plane just came down in Keene near the airport, right next to Hope Chapel. Oh my God. That is intense. Wow. Oh my God, whoever's in that plane died. Oh my God. That's an apartment building that it's on right now. Oh my God. What?
Get out. Oh, the plane crashed.
I heard it.
And we heard it too.
Oh, there's the tail of it.
I know.
Unbelievable.
Hey, Daddy. Is that a house or a barn?
That's the barn. The house is on the other side. The apartment. It's gonna be. They're all connected.
Oh, Brian, hi. The plane crashed into a house.
What?
Would it be the plane?
I heard it backfire.
Oh, my God. Jeff, you call 911?
Yeah.
On
paper? Yeah.
Oh, my God. Oh,
well, whoever's in the plane is not in the plane anymore.
Oh my God.
That whole building's gonna go up.
I heard the bang.
Oh.
I looked that way, I didn't see anything. I looked back this way. So.
I want to make sure that I don't think we can get any closer because that thing will, it might just blow up.
Yeah, I don't think we can even get close.
That's already gone. Any fuel that's in that is that's what's causing that fire. Wow. All the air pooling fuel's already burnt off. This is just the building burning now. Well, that's true. We don't know if the guy stores a whole bunch of propane and gasoline. Always something going on around here.
Wayne Brown is up there.
Yep. Heat is intense. I'm a good 500-600 feet away from this thing and I can feel this heat. Crazy. sorry, it's their house. I'm thinking this could have been my house just as easy. Wow. You see the tail of the plane? Zoom in. Tail of the airplane's right there. This is just a barn, but there's an apartment building attached to the side of this.
Your
stuff. That's just unbelievable.
How sad is this? He said, "Hi, are you okay?" Oh my God! Look at the inside the house. Oh my God. Where is the fire department?
They're out there.
Where is the fire department?
They're out there. They're out front.
They need to
be
here.
They're right there. They don't even know what to do yet, so they have to figure out what they're going to do before they go. So they got to hose us out now.
Oh, dear God.
There goes one tank.
It's massive. I'm standing here with everybody in the neighborhood. It is massive, this fog. That hot, we took my house out, and all of a sudden we turned around and saw the plane coming over our house, and the sand in our house, it crashed at the whole top chapel in that barn right beside it, and it, Dad was running to it to see if anybody could get out, but it immediately set on fire, and the entire thing was on fire massively right now. Yeah, that's just a lot.
Unbelievable.
Now this is a problem. Oh no, it's fast.
Any luck they can get the people out of the building and save the building next to it. With that thing so intense, I don't know. The barn isn't inhabited by anybody, but I'm not sure what's ever in there. That barn's been in this neighborhood for years. I grew up sneaking into it when I was a kid. This is gone. It is just gone.
Hey, John.
Hey. Never a dull moment around here.
Tough neighborhood. Look at that. You notice the branches looking like in the trees? Some flies are coming in here.
It's going right over down the road.
I was thinking about that myself.
That was the garage next to
it. This could be pretty bad with all these dry leaves around here, too.
Oh, I know, really. No kidding.
Well, they're here. Yeah. There goes that. Yeah, they pretty good. Yeah, they were yelling at each other to get out.
Crash, and he did too, so he came over to Mary, and oh my, right behind the, right in the Hope Tackle parking lot.
Yeah.
And Dad saw it.
Your video. You have my head.
Looks like they got the ladder up overhead now. The lights on it. Inside and I heard it and I said that something crashed and I thought something happened in the backyard for crying out loud and I came running out and
I said
smoke pouring out over the trees and like I could see all this stuff and I'm like oh my god that thing was just completely engulfed that even within like not even like a minute went by.
Full fuel tank of fuel.
I imagine, yeah.
You knew something was happening, banging, and it was coming over the house, and it just, so the engine just died.
Right. Wow.
So lucky it didn't hit that apartment.
Yeah. Exactly. That or any of our houses.
Yeah.
Just a quick pick.
No.
No. Wow, I just cannot believe this.
couldn't see
the thing that I always think of when you're playing for the bicycle.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Unfortunately, I was right. At least there's a garage.
It looks like they're gonna be able to save the apartment buildings. They're really on this thing.
Yeah.
They just got to get this corner out.
You know Wayne Brown, huh? You know Wayne Brown?
Yeah. There you go. I don't exactly know what else is in that garage, you know.
Wow.
You know, if they're, anything that's going to store like fuel or whatever, it's just going to make it worse. I heard something pop. I'm not sure what it was. Fire's still way up on the top. It looks like it's heading into the attic. Oh, no. If that hits the attic, that building's gone, too. I don't know, but... I thought they had the ladder, right? They came running out there. Everybody could hear running around the building out there. He's like, get out, now, get out. So, with any luck, everybody's out. And they were out within a minute or two. And this happened so fast that, you know, if that was somebody's house, I don't think you'd even get a chance to get out of the thing. Guys, get that house out too.
Yeah, we're all
of all the dry leaves around here, thinking, oh, that'd be great, you know. This could just, like, track right along to somebody's place easily.
Right.
Three-alarm fire now?
Well, there goes the property value. Nobody's going to want to live here now.
Oh, it's pre-disaster. Remember that movie years ago?
I was just going to say...
Garp,
The Life of Garp.
The Life of Garp, yeah. Oh, yeah, this is pre-disaster.
You know what the chances are of a plane never hitting there?
That's right. You got a sick sense of humor, man. This is a disaster, and you're making fun. This is sad. All I can say is, if it did hit the house, this would have been way worse.
Yeah.
You know, I always say, God had meant people to fly, they'd have put wings on them. This is... You're going against the tides here.
The FAA will definitely be looking into it.
Oh, yeah. Well, you know, those private airplanes, they, you know, who really maintains them? And, you know, they have to do
you know, reports on them and stuff.
But really, that's, yeah, that's not something that people really do. You think, oh, it was skipping a little bit, it'll be all right. How many times you've driven your car and some little thing happens, you're like, yeah, whatever. Check engine light comes on, keep driving. You know? But, you know, an airplane like this, you know, skip a little bit like that in the engine. Could have had water in the fuel.
Right.
Who knows? There was another plane that went up. Probably some of my whole chapel of hills get out of here.
Hey.
Oh, it's John O'Brien.
How are you guys? No, we just got back at 5 o'clock today. Yeah.
Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah.
Gains will be a
And your house Brian was in the yard. Brian was in the yard, and all of a sudden he was getting out with Maverick. He was sitting there, and all of a sudden he had a Maverick fire and throws Maverick in. He saw them. He immediately wanted to go and save anybody, and I was behind the door. I know, I didn't want to do it. How many of us going to be at the next airport meeting?
I guess you got to get a petition saying you can't fly over our houses anymore. Come in from the other end.
Yeah, they can't, though, because that's all to do with wind. You know, what they can do, though, is they can stop that flight school from going over our houses all the time. The helicopters are not supposed to be over here, but they're going over more and more now. I'm just getting sore.
Well, they thought it was a church, actually. They said that. They said it was a church.
Nobody's in there, right?
I don't know. Friday night, sometimes they do. They have stuff in there.
If you've got it bad.
Just so great. So good it wasn't that house.
I know. Huh. I don't know how many people it could have displaced, too.
Yeah.
People living in
the frame, when we came around, the window was closed. the planes are shooting like 50 feet.
I could see them really good.
I could see it from my apartment. I was like,
go down the end here and you look straight.
You gotta make sure. And he's like, oh,
right in the line. Yeah. Right in the line.
I heard it, but I didn't really pay much attention until I hear that crash.
Went, boom. Engine stopped, and then a few seconds later, boom.
Right. Well, I haven't definitely heard that. I just come back inside from being out.
Did
they
wake you up?
Oh, wow, a tree fall down or something?
No. No, not exactly. It's pretty scary, because that's too close to home.
It is.
I heard it.
Yeah.
You're getting close enough, John. You guys are
Yes. Yes.
And then it was a little funny.
Yeah, it fired into the fence, so and then weird. So he stepped out and thumbs up, and I said, it's a big ball.
Yeah. I think they saved the house, though.
It definitely is.
Good. Good. I hate to see people ruined out.
Yeah. If anything, I mean, it's maybe some smoke damage in there.
I didn't get over far enough to see, and I wasn't going to get yelled at, so I stayed stay my distance. Yeah.
Just say your ex-fire department.
I could use my city.
Yeah, say your city inspector.
Okay.
Right, part-time off, city inspector.
Off time.
John, I was going to go over and say I was the building inspector.
Yeah, this place should be condemned. I wouldn't want to live there.
That could be.
Yeah, what time is it now? It's a quick decision.
Wow. What a change. Remember, they're messing, playing around in that garage when I was a kid, sneaking in it, looking around.
I don't think the weather was going to come out.
I hear the radio.
It had to heat up in cars when they had melted inside of it.
Right. I called and I said, whoops. Somebody mobile. I said, yeah, it's on Lower Main Street. I don't have the number. It's right next to the hotel.
I don't know.
Right to the fire.
We were coming over.
Yeah, because I don't know how long it was. It was off somewhere. Yeah, I don't know who it was. I have no clue.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
So that really maximum of nothing brings people together like a good old house fire, huh? Yeah.
You know, it was a thing on the internet today. That, what's a sound that you used to hear when you were kids? You don't hear anymore. I was thinking they'll be on fire all night.
Oh, yeah. They're going to have to. Somebody's got to sit here and watch that.
You could tell where the fires were. Right, really? Yeah.
Yeah. As an alarm, you could count the feet.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, I remember that.
Yeah,
you don't hear that. They used to have the light there up on Main Street too to let you know if there was any fatalities or anything in the city. It's all gone. The little light hook poles up there. Right, yeah, pushing the water right to it up there. That's
really particular.
No.
That's great, though. I mean, if that can be that direct and it can keep the...
I don't think it's me. I think it's just one of those...
automated things. Yeah. Cool.
Yeah, good. Unless they're up there in school, though.
Yeah, they'd have to be. Yeah, can't imagine.
Bad stuff.
Yeah. We just put that vinyl siding on not that long ago.
Wow, man.
I don't know if you feel like that. That's fine. Not my fence. Yeah, but it was just soft. Oh, yeah. Don't leave any fingerprints. I wore gloves.
Uh. That's pretty cool. Check out the lights on that thing.
I know, right?
They really bling that thing right up. I never seen anything like that before. Yeah, that thing's still on fire in there. You can still see. Actually, up on the wall, there's like a little flamey area there. So it's still going in there. But I think they're so concerned on just keeping the house from going up.
I know. Well, there's a thing up there, too. I got a giant. Yeah. You see the lights on the garage? Yeah. Come on.
You know what? I think I want to be a fireman. I'm going to go get a fireman. Oh, I'm not going to go inside. I'm going to drive the truck. I'm going to hang my head out the window and make the woo-woo sounds.
I think they've stopped traffic. Period. They aren't even letting them down through here.
No.
If those are cops, they meet.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
Oh, those Halloween donuts with little pumpkins on them? Those are good, man.
I used to meet Steve Corrigan when I worked. He worked in the used to happen with that city hall. So I worked weekends then, and I was pretty good friends with him. We used to mess with each other. Right? When I bought Jones Fowler's Lincoln, I parked out in Washington. He gave me a $3,500 ticket.
Okay.
Bid on Monday.
So he's talking to somebody that's looking for directions or something. I interrupt him. Excuse me, officer. Can you tell me where the donut shop is? He's like, this is a gun.
He draws his gun.
And then we were scrapping around in the jail, in the cells. And we were rustling around. Because one of the young cops thought we were really going at it.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, whoops.
He was going to jump in and save us. Or me, one or the other. I don't think it was going to save me.
How did you get over here, John? Did you jump the fence? Did you walk all the way around?
I walked around the
corner. Yeah.
Yeah.
They're still sending shit here.
What's that, four now? There's a four alarm fire now. No, they already were down here. I had to take the RV down, take it for a ride to change the oil in it. And as soon as I get near the fairgrounds, traffic accident. So I'm just sitting there going, are you kidding me? I just can't even get out of here.
Oh, did you see that fire in like Raymond or Epping on the right hand side of the road?
No. No, I didn't see it. Nope, did not see it.
Is that a fire truck on fire?
Could have been.
Is that a possibility?
Yeah, how do you put that out?
Self-extinguishing.
You were right, we got home for maybe 5 minutes of fire.
You got home for 4 minutes.
You stopped?
Yep.
Then, okay, we
took gas and
yeah, no, we just kept going. Do you go through the city?
No, not through the city. Well, you can see the beams of the city.
Right, okay, we do that.
Yeah.
Yeah, we do that. I don't know, I think it's all the same.
And then, I got home.
Okay, we were just like, maybe, we were probably 2 minutes. I didn't see you, you know, pass or whatever.
No.
I was kept looking and I didn't.
80 most of the way.
Yeah, exactly. Even in the 30s.
That's just a suggested thing.
Yeah,
30. Yeah, do what
like
you want.
The Dominican Republic.
Yeah, it's only a suggestion.
Speed limits are mere suggestions.
Do we need to clap now?
Because well, most of it, the highway, Jonathan, is 70 anyways.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. I was came back from the Seacoast with the RV, and it's like people are ripping around me, and I'm going like 70. I'm like,
yeah,
wow.
You're away.
I'm in the way. I can't go any faster. That's the fastest thing. It's still going in there.
We didn't run into any
slowdowns. No, we didn't either. Nothing. And I didn't see the smoke. Ginny was probably sleeping, otherwise she would have been
Yeah, we didn't stop. We didn't have to pee.
Yeah.
That's, I mean, that's very important when you get out of
my... I'm getting it.
Yeah, she's like, I'm driving. I'm not answering the phone. Maybe we're going to go over. That's her. She's going to go over to cross the street. We're here.
Come out here in the morning and take a picture of it again with a airplane top maybe sticking out of it. There can't be much left of that thing. They're all made out of aluminum. They're just going to be or fabric in some cases.
Yeah, there isn't much left. What is the chainsaw? Saw, whatever it is.
I don't know.
What? Maybe the apartment?
The sidewall or something? Well, they have to get all the equipment out to justify having it.
Well, that's true.
So, you know, they're out there just cutting up wood.
Wow. Hopefully nobody in the apartment's affected by it.
Yeah. I mean, I can hear people yelling to get out and get out, get out when I came running over here, so. Everybody get out.
Oh, in the apartment?
Yeah. Oh, this is all connected. It's probably all full of smoke now. It's going to be a major smoke damage in there.
No, we were in the house, and I heard the plane. I can't really say it was struggling, but the motor just stopped. And then, like, a second later, boom. It's like, Ginny, that plane just crashed. We went out back and it was flying. So, it's just like that.
Yeah.
I didn't see it. Somebody said they saw the tail sticking out.
Yeah, you can see the tail sticking out of the top.
I'm going to ask me to take a wash my car.
So I just went, drive in. Hey, give me $5.
You know, your windows will be blown out, yeah. And the interior will be clean too.
But we'll give it a wash. She is scared.
Rolling over.
She's anxious. I told her there's just no way that's coming over here. You know, if it was anything different, we'd have been running ourselves. But yeah, she does. She has anxiety issues, so.
all right. Do me a favor, you guys are totally good where you're at, so we're going to be putting some tape around the whole area. Obviously, it's going to be trying to secure it here, right?
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'm not. Oh, okay. I'm sorry. Oh, Andy Boston, nice to meet you.
Yep.
Where are you? I'm sorry, say that again, where are you?